what would you like to tell our great audience tonight about what you've been doing this year?
I retired from the Board of Ed as a guidance counselor, so now I'm devoting everything to mainly to singing, and I've been writing songs and making music. I hope to do a CD. I know I promised to do it at the end of this year, but I had to put my deadline a little forward, so hopefully early spring I can have my own CD.
Oh, good. We'll have you back on the show to play all the whole CD.
Exactly. It's mostly going to be original songs, but I'm going to throw a couple of covers in there also.
What are some of the unique people that you've worked with in this industry?
So many, and as a matter of fact, I was just telling
Eddie. Look at this great group. Look at this picture. Look at this, Jeff. We're holding up this great picture of these super girls, these great girls here. See that? That's great, isn't it?
Yeah.
What do you say about this,
Annette? It's not only a super group musically, but each girl brings so much to the group. And besides being terrific in the music business and the voices, great hearts, really a great bunch of people, right from the past.
When did you first meet Lillian?
I guess it was going back quite a few years.
What do you call it? That place in Brooklyn where they used to give the show?
Metro Tech.
We went to see a Wilson Pickett show.
We did. And we were introduced the person introduced us knew that we would get along very well and that we were coming from a lot of the same background.
Mm-hmm.
Music, so it worked out.
And the Beatles, right?
Oh, yeah, definitely. Beatles. I think that was one of my most favorite highlights of my career, was doing the Beatle tour for 6 weeks. Throughout the United States, we hit every city in the United States.
Which all the cities that you hit, was there one specific city that you recall more than another?
Well, I remember most of them because I have a good memory. But the most fun that I always tell people about is when we were in Florida, in Key West, Florida, because we had a couple of days off, so we had jam sessions with the Beatles. Oh my goodness, they were so awesome! They could play anything. They knew more about blues and R&B than we did.
Can you imagine?
Because that was their background. Although George was John. He told us that he studied classical, so he knew a little classical. But that night he played a little classical for us to show us, and then we just sang. And they at first they didn't have their instruments, but we were like really getting in the groove. They said, "Wait a minute, let's go get our axes." That's what they used to call guitars in those days.
Very warm man, wasn't he, John?
Oh, very nice. I'm telling you, I don't know about now because I haven't seen them in many, many years. But back then, we were like 17, 18, 19, 20. They were awesome. Awesome musicians, awesome personalities, just as people. We had really, really a lot of fun with them.
And Annette, so what are you doing these days? Where are you exactly?
I've been a teacher for many years, a Catholic school teacher. I taught third and fourth grade for many years. That was my dream.
Aren't kids the best?
Wild and wonderful, right? But along with that, I had always sung with Fred Barnett and the Delrons for many, many years. And I never stopped singing. Even when the group broke up, I was with another group called the Tercevils, and we're still together. And then I'm with Supergirl. But I wanted to tell you something funny about the Beatles that was kind of funny thing. When we were in England, we did two tours of England as Rep Rodham and the Delrons. We had the first tour. It was just a wonderful tour. We had our captain of your ship. That was a single there. We were getting ready, and we were very much traveling throughout England. And we had heard that John and Paul were waiting to see us. No one had ever told us. And they waited downstairs for several hours. And when we found out, we were heartbroken. I don't know if they ever found out. We didn't know.
What year was that? Do you recall? Or about? Somewhere. 68?
Yes. Yeah, went twice in. So, we had a lot of fun. It's been, when you're in this business for so many years, and kind of we grew up in the business, we had to learn so much, and we really had a lot of different problems over the years, and of course, we never made the money. We were supposed to know the whole story. But overall, it's something that we love. It's in our hearts, and that's it. No matter what you go through, we go through a lot.
Leslie Becker, she's going to be joining us soon, a Broadway star and recording artist, Patrick Van Burak, you know, some of the new artists that we have on the show, the old artists, every artist, anybody that's... There's so many great people out there that have so much great voices
and
want to get their music out there, so this show is a great way of doing it. What would you like to say, though, about the CD? Is there any... I know you've been working on that for a while. Hey, Rob, how you doing?
Just that I wrote the lyrics and the music and the musical arrangement for about 10 of the songs. It's something that I guess I've been known how to do it all along, but it's just I discovered that I have talent in that area. So working it out.
Excellent. Well, we're going to write something for Nanette.
She's going to do her CD. If I don't write it for her, she's never going to do it. So I'm going to do it for her.
And then you can sing here on WPAC, right? Promise?
Yes, I
do. Tell us about Tell Him before we play. Anything that comes to your mind that you want to share with us tonight?
Oh, I always tell the joke that. Well, Tell Him was recorded by a man by the name of Johnny Thunder. So when they gave us Lieber and Stoller, when I say they, I mean Lieber and Stoller, when they gave us the demo to go home and learn, well, we liked it, but we didn't think it was us, and we had our own songs that we wanted to record. So we got together and decided when we get back to the studio, we're going to tell Lieber and Stoller that we just don't like it and we don't want to do it. So when we got to the studio, we said... we've been thinking, and we decided that we'd like to record something else. We don't really like it. So Lieber and Stoller told us, okay, just try it. So we said, okay. And it's a lucky thing we did.
We're playing it here. Lillian Walker from the Exciters here. WPAT, Tell Him. How are you, Rob?
Good, how are you?
Good. Thanks for coming down tonight.
Absolutely.
We have a party at 9 o'clock. Thanks for coming, John. Get you on the mic in a few minutes. We're talking about that in a second. Let's talk about that. That's very important. A lot of young people like listening to 50s music, you know. A lot of traditional corporate radio won't play a lot of that. And the alternatives, some of the alternative stations, the walking stations, are playing a lot of the alternative stuff. You know, a lot of the news is driven by ratings or walking in along the other one. Whatever a teenager. Sing us a live one tonight. Anyway, we're back here. We're live here in the studio. I believe this is still a studio. Yeah, okay. This is Teddy Smith Studio right here, Studio E, and a James Petrecka production. Got it, right? Anyway, so the Teddy Smith is here, along with Nanette Licari, Lillian Walker, and you were telling me during the break, a lot of young folks are listening to all of this great music that I know that I play here, 50s and 60s music here at WPAT. Mm. Could you share some of those thoughts with us tonight?
Whenever we do our gigs, and no matter where we are, and even the Supergirls and other groups that we've been in, the reaction is, sometimes we would go and think, oh, they're not going to want to hear us, and I don't know what's going to happen, they may get booed, but the reaction is incredible. They really enjoy the harmony, which you wouldn't think, you know. Mm-hmm. They like the words, they like everything about it, and it's so heartwarming to see it, because when you think that they may not, they absolutely do. Definitely.
And, you know, wherever a teenager...
Never a teenager cries.
Whatever, this is one of great hit, one of these terrific songs that you're on right here, and brings back not only great memories, but I believe it was back in 64 or thereabouts, right?
Yes,
probably. What is some of those other two young ladies in that picture right
okay,
now?
Okay.
See, over there?
Yeah, that was the original, actually it was the original girl. They were only together a year and a half. So that's Carol Drobnicki to the right, the blonde, she passed away. Quite a few years ago, actually. And this reporter in the middle, Mary Iazzi. And the other side is Sheila Riley. She's a principal in public school system in New Jersey. But they were happy to have their hit, because I knew reporter from high school, and actually in elementary school. But what happened was they had to do two tours, and they were very grueling, so they didn't want to do the second tour. And when that happened, Mary remembered me as being a close friend and a singer, so... I was aboard right after that.
Well, let's play that song. I'm glad you could make it down here this evening for the Teddy Smith 6-year annual radio reunion hour, power hour, 2 hours of nonstop music and fun. PAT.
PAT. WPAT.
WPAT.
That's it. And lots of fun here for the 6-year anniversary.
Thank you.
For sure.
Thanks for joining us. Got it.
Tell me.
AM 930, New York, it's WPAT.